This is SAP Developer News.
It's the end of another year, and it's time to look back on what that year has given us. For SAP developers, we've seen a lot of great new offerings, from the SAP BTP free tier to the introduction of the Kima runtime in SAP BTP and the acquisition of AppGyver, just to name a few. My fellow SAP developer advocates are going to detail more of what's new in their particular topic area, but I thought I would discuss a few of the items that our team itself, the developer advocates, have accomplished this year. Thanks to the ongoing COVID pandemic, we continue to bring you as much content as we can in an online format and try to do that as interactively as possible. We continue to do live stream events and hold online events like Devtoberfest, which we brought back this year, bigger and better than ever. I hope that everybody enjoyed it. We also saw a major accomplishment in the form of the developer keynote as a part of TechEd this year. And if you haven't checked out either all the content from Devtoberfest or the content from TechEd yet, it's all available online for you to be able to catch up with. Now that said, we hope that maybe in 2022, we'll see the return of some in-person events. We would love to be able to get back out there and meet and interact with our fellow developers face-to-face, but of course, only if it's safe to do so. If we do, we'll try to bridge the world of online and create as many hybrid events as we can. We know that we'll all probably only be able to gather in small numbers, so we'll try to also extend those in-person events to the online world as well. That has us thinking about what we might do bigger and better next year. So tune in and have a look at what we're able to do again next year.
The developer advocates are constantly trying to find the right balance of content type and style when it comes to producing material to help you be successful. One of those content types is video, and I wanted to take a quick look over 2021 to see how we fared. It seems that you really like what we produce on the SAP Developers YouTube channel. This year, we had almost 500,000 views and over 36,000 hours of watch time. As you can see from the graph, Devtoberfest was a pretty popular event. The top videos reflected your interest in solid topics such as SAP HANA, SAP Business Application Studio, SAP Cloud Application Programming Model, and of course, ABAP. And while our main content across different shows, such as SAP Developer News, SAP Tech Bytes, and SAP Samples Spotlight, provide the bulk of the material, I'm personally proud to see how well our live streams are doing. From humble beginnings over on Twitch almost 2 years ago now, to a regular show here on the SAP Developers channel. We're looking forward to producing more content across all media for you in 2022. Happy holidays.
Hey folks, Rich Heilman here, developer advocate, SAP Devs. So I just wanted to take a minute and share some of the 2021 highlights around the ABAP topics that we reported on in the developer news this year. It's been a great year for ABAP. We started the year with a new ABAP Dev Edition, which runs on Docker, and it's super easy to get started quickly. We've had several updates to the wrap generator, and of course, we just recently learned that the wrap generator has now been integrated into ABAP development tools and provides a wizard for generating wrap repository objects. Several releases of Steampunk have brought us many new features to help us with our ABAP application development in the cloud. And of course, the big news around embedded Steampunk availability in SAP S/4HANA Cloud, which now allows developers to create custom code in a cloud-ready way directly in the SAP S/4HANA Cloud system. So, lots of good stuff around ABAP in 2021. I'm very much looking forward to lots more ABAP goodness in 2022.
Thank you, Rich. There has been some really great highlights this year for ABAP. One, including our new series for developers who are interested in stepping into learning ABAP. This series is for anyone new to the SAP technology and are confused on where to start. The aim and the goal of these blog posts and videos is to guide you through your journey as an ABAP developer. Speaking of the series, we have now uploaded our part 3 video where we learn how to create and run an ABAP application. Stay tuned for upcoming videos and blog posts on this series in the upcoming year.
One of the highlights for me this year was the release of version 3 of the Easy UI5 generator, which is an open source tool that simplifies the task of initializing and scaffolding UI5 based projects and breaks it down to just a single command. The tool was featured in the UI5Con keynote this year, as version 3 saw a major architectural change of the project. It is now divided into separate repositories for the generator runner, Easy UI5, and the generators themselves, for example for UI5 projects or libraries. These generators are fetched as plugins for the generator runner on demand, and this modular structure makes it easier for the community to contribute to existing generators and also to create new ones. Another highlight for me this year was the evolution of the SAP Launchpad service for the SAP BTP. We have some very interesting blog posts out there in the SAP community, displaying a variety of features and services that can be integrated with the SAP Launchpad service. Marius Obert, for example, explained how to send notifications from SAP BTP apps to end users of the SAP Fiori Launchpad. In another post, he demonstrated how to use the managed app router approach in combination with the SAP Launchpad service in order to deploy web apps to Cloud Foundry serverlessly. You no longer have to deploy several app router apps as entry points, but can leverage the SAP Launchpad service and the HTML5 application repository to have a single entry point that doesn't require much configuration or maintenance, and no application runtime at all.
This year was an exciting year, and first, I want to thank you as the community for being a great part of SAP and making our job fun every day. For today, I want to quickly talk about my highlights for this year. We start with the SAP BTP SDK for iOS, because it has published a great set of new repositories on GitHub for our consumption. My favorite ones are the Fiori AR for simple AR functionality. Also, we got a cool API to integrate into SAP Conversational AI. And finally, multi-user support for our apps, including multi-user onboarding. Also, Devtoberfest, another highlight for me, as we revamped the concept of Devtoberfest to give you insight into SAP tech, but also general topics like Kubernetes, security, and even best practices for developers. The Fun Friday events were also pretty fun. But my biggest highlight was SAP TechEd. I had the great honor to be not only part of the developer keynote, but also do moderation for Channel 1 together with Cecily Sorensen. And, as I said, being part of the developer keynote together with my lovely colleagues. So you should head over to YouTube and check out the developer keynote and the Channel 1 recordings if you have missed that. I'm looking forward to next year for new experiences to evolve and learn. So I hope you all have a great holiday season and a happy new year.
2021 is coming to the end, and what an intensive year it was. Here are a few things I'd like to mention. This year, SAP HANA Cloud got multiple new components, including Data Lake Files and Data Lake IQ, allowing data engineers to build solutions that scale in a very cost-efficient way. Hopefully, you've seen me presenting SQL on files during the developer keynote of SAP TechEd. In SAP Analytics Cloud, I've seen Analytics Designer and Augmented Analytics, especially predictive planning, were driving a lot of interest among customers and partners in 2021. A lot of projects were involving data warehousing again. Two big announcements from this year were the availability of the BW Bridge and the Data Marketplace for SAP Data Warehouse Cloud. SAP Data Intelligence continues its expansion as the central component connecting all SAP and non-SAP data. Operators integrating SAP HANA Cloud Data Lake and SAP Data Warehouse Cloud were introduced this year. I'm looking forward to 2022. Let's learn and build stuff, turning data into value. And most importantly, let's have fun doing that. Happy New Year, everyone.
I bet on a beard that we won't be able to use any of these.
If you've never tried SAP's artificial intelligence, read the script.
The top videos reflected your interest in solid topics such as SAP.
If you've never tried SAP conversational artificial intelligence, now is the time. SAP wants to help you revolutionize, wants to help you.
SAP developer community come together for six.
We're gonna get some more.
Okay, so then. Hey everybody, Josh Bentley, developer advocate, and I am excited. I cannot talk.
3, 2, 1.
Live!
Kanneh!
Take two!
Microservices is a misunderstood concept in a lot of pieces.
The December 2021 release of the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model.
Hey everybody, Josh Bentley,